Please welcome the director and co-writer, Bong Joon-ho. And let's see. Oh my gosh, he is the star. He plays the patriarch of the Kim family. He's made four films with you now, and the top star in South Korea. And now I think internationally, you're going to be hearing a lot from him. Song Kang-ho. And as Ki Jung, please welcome Park So Dem.
Hello. And you go right down there.
And this is Sharon and this is Lewis. They are our interpreters here. Well, congratulations. You can see this is sold out. It's on every screen in this theater complex, I think, and it's selling out everywhere. Did you have any idea when you came upon this movie, to do this movie, that it would have the impact it's having around the world? It's already a huge hit in your own country and now here, obviously, too.
뭐 전혀 상상 못했었고요. 어떻게 완성이나 해보자 이런 생각으로 했죠.
I never imagined it. I was only focused on just finishing the movie.
LA에서 이렇게 관객분들 직접 만나서 너무 기쁩니다.
I'm so happy to meet you all here in LA.
Yeah. This is a movie that really takes you by surprise. I bet you guys didn't know where it was going when it went there, I can safely say. And that's great, you know, because sometimes movies become very predictable. But this one you have called a tragicomedy, which I think is an interesting term. Can you talk about the concept for the movie and what you were going for in that way?
뭐 한국말로 하면 희비극. 예. 뭐 코미디이면서도 비극이다라는 건데 제가 뭐 시나리오 쓸 때부터 그런 계획을 갖고 쓰는 건 아니거든요. 뭐 일단 막 씁니다. 쓸 때는. 예.
So tragicomedy, it's basically comedy and tragedy, but that's not something that I planned during the script writing stage. I just wrote.
그 마케팅 팀들이 항상 그래서 괴로워해요. 이 도대체 감독님 이게 장르가 뭐예요라고 힘들어하는데요. 예.
So the marketing team always suffers. They always ask me, so what genre is this movie?
사실 저도 잘 모르거든요. 그 이게 예. 저는 뭐 원래 인간이 원래 감정이 희노애락이 다 있고 그러니까 그냥 그걸 자연스럽게 다 섞어서 하는 건데 뭐 보는 분들은 좀 희한한가 봐요. 그래서 깐데에서 어떤 분이 그 미국 기자분이 뭐 그냥 봉준호 장르다. 딱히 너무 고민하지 말자 이런 얘기를 해서 저는 속으로 되게 기뻤습니다.
To be honest, I don't know either. I think that human emotion is always a mixture of sadness and happiness and joy and suffering. So I just naturally mix all those emotions into my stories. But I suppose for the audience, it may feel a little strange. When I was in Cannes, some American reporter commented on how there's really no need to think about the genre of Bong Joon-ho's films. Bong Joon-ho is a genre unto himself.
That's a good way of putting it, for sure, yeah. And there's always something in them, whether it's Oksha or Snowpiercer or Memories of Murder or on and on. They all have a social element here and something way beyond just a genre, if we're going to use that term. And is that something you're conscious of, that you have a lot to say, but you want to say it in a way that people are going to listen?
사실 뭐 어떤 정치적인 주제나 무슨 사회적인 코멘트를 하려고 영화를 만든 적은 없고요. 이렇게 항상 장르적인 흥분 내지는 재미가 있는 영화를 하려고 하는데 그 대신 제가 캐릭터 이제 여기 뭐 우리 주인공분들 계시지만은 인물들한테 관심이 많다 보니까 인물들에 대해서 자꾸 이렇게 파내려 가다 보면 예, 왠지
So to be honest, I don't create films to deliver a particularly political message or provide social commentary. I really pursue the excitement and entertainment that comes from genre itself. But I always have a lot of interest in characters and individuals.
근데 그 개인을 파내려가다 보니까 왠지 점점 파내려갈수록 뭐 사회, 역사랑 저절로 연결이 되나 봐요. 이렇게 뛸래야 뛸 수 없나 봐요. 제가 뭐 무인도에서 평생 사는 사람 영화를 찍지 않는 이상은. 예.
But the deeper I delve into these individuals, the more I come to, you know, explore society and history. They're basically inseparable. And so unless I create a film about a man who lives on an isolated island, I think they will always go hand in hand.
Song Kang-ho, phenomenal performance, as always with you. Yes.
Thank you. Very nice to meet you.
And I know you're used to working with him, so you sort of have a secondhand rhythm with each other at this point now. You were in Snowpiercer, you're in Memories of Murder, and other movies, four movies, I think, all together now. So what is... like working with him, you and him together.
한 20년 같이 이제 쭉 해왔죠. 그런데 이제 봉준호 감독이 조금 전에 아주 좋은 말씀 해주신 것 같은데, 지금 기생충도 사실은 뭐 어떤 빈부의 격차, 뭐 이런 갈등, 뭐 이런 어떻게 보면 되게 이렇게 어떻게 보면 좀 작은 얘기를 이렇게 얘기하는 것 같은 영화인 것 같지만 사실은 봉준호 감독의 거대한 야심이 숨겨져 있는 작품이 아닌가. 그러니까 20년 전부터 봉준호 감독은 항상 작품을 통해서 그런 거대한 야심을 작품 속에 녹아 들게끔 했던 그런 감독이라서 정말 너무나 매번 놀랍고 존경하는 그런 마음으로 작업을 해왔습니다.
So Director Bong and I have been working together for the past 20 years, and I think Director Bong just said something really amazing. You know, Parasite seems to be a small story about class struggle and conflict, but actually it conceals Director Bong's grand ambitions to tell these stories about the human condition. And you know, during the past 20 years, he's always managed to melt those grand schemes into his stories. So every time I'm surprised, I have so much respect for Director Bong.
Yeah. I say that too for how many people here might have seen Memories of Murder? Okay. Whoa. Wow, that's really impressive. Wow. But if you've been reading the news, he just confessed. So he was just found. This is 20 years later, you know.
It's pretty amazing
to see how far your film goes and how relevant it remains, too.
그 저도 그 사건 보고 기사를 보고 되게 놀랐었는데 얼굴을 봤어요. 그 범인의 얼굴을 신문에 나온 되게 복잡한 감정이 들더라고요. 그 형님과 그 영화를 17년 전에 찍을 때도 와, 이 살인범은 정말 어떻게 생긴 사람일까 궁금했었는데. 예.
So I was very surprised when I read that article as well, and I was able to see a photo of his face printed on the newspaper, and I felt very complicated. I remember 17 years ago when we were filming the film, Song and I, we wondered what he actually looks like.
Actually, movie The Zodiac by David Fincher,
yeah.
In the very last moment of the movie, Jake Gyllenhaal actually visits the place, and finally he confronts the murderer there. And 그런 비슷한 감정을 받았죠. 그 제이크 질레놀 감정이 그게 뭔지 이제 좀 알겠더라고요. 보니까.
And I felt something similar. Now I understand what Jake Gyllenhaal was feeling in that scene.
You know, and I think that's what I was talking about, these issues that your movies bring up. And I think Parasite, no matter where people see it, they're going to be able to relate to this. And the things that it talks about, that's why it's successful around the world. And Park So-dam, you're wonderful too. And I have some papers I'd like you to forge for me.
really?
Can you talk about this and working with this fantastic cast, this wonderful ensemble cast, and what you got out of it in this experience and what you get out of the film thematically here?
이분들을 얻었습니다.
I'm walking away with these amazing people that I work with. That's what I gained.
정말 좋은 영화를 한 것도 너무나 좋았고 기정이란 인물을 연기하면서도 너무나 신이 났었는데 정말 영화를 다 찍고 또 그 이후를 계속해서 생각을 하다 보니 정말 사람이 남는다라는 말이 뭔지 정말 많이 느끼고 있는 것 같아요. 그래서 너무 감사하고 감사합니다.
throughout the entire process of shooting this film, I was just really excited about it, and just it doesn't come around every day. But after I shot everything and rewrapped, and if I think about it more, and even to this day, I really do believe that like every project you work with, you walk away with the people that you met and the people that are gonna go with you forever. And just for that, I thank you. And I think thank you is the only thing I can keep saying, but thank you.
Acting-wise, Song, can you talk about the process here? Is it all on the page? Do you follow it line for line, his script, or do you improvise? Or
네, 여러분들 보신 그 살인의 추억 같은 영화는 좀 감독님 그죠? 그 현장에서의 어떤 그 즉흥적인 어떤 감정에 굉장히 좀 많이 그런 쪽을 좀 중시 이렇게 했던 그런 영화였다면 페러사이트 같은 경우는 아주 정교한 대사와 동선을 맞춰서 최대한 그렇게 맞춰왔던 그런 영화였던 것 같아요. 작품마다 좀 틀린 것 같아요. 예.
So for a film like Memories of Murder, I was really faithful to the spontaneous emotion that reached me on set. So there was a lot that we improvised. But Parasite had very meticulous lines and coordinating in terms of blocking. So it really depends on the project.
송강호님이 참 놀라운 게 뭐냐면은 그러니까 임프로바이저 그러니까 즉흥 연기를 해도 그게 씬이나 영화의 맥락에 너무 정확하게 오히려 더 그걸 강화시켜가지고 마치 뭐 1년 전부터 이렇게 준비된 조직된 대사인 것처럼 느껴지게 만들고 또 반면 오래 전부터 써놓은 대사도 너무나 싱싱하게 그냥 날 것처럼 하기 때문에 써져 있는 대사인데도 꼭 애드립 같기도 하고 그래서 그 경계를 흐트려 버리시는 것 같아요. 그래서 그런 게 볼 때마다 참 감탄 놀라워요. 가까이서 봐도.
What's really surprising about Song is that even when he improvises on set, it only strengthens the scene and the overall context of the film and never sticks out. And and so it feels like it's a line that he's been practicing the past year. And even, you know, with dialogue that was written a long time ago, he makes it feel raw and, you know, just alive and vital. So he always manages to blur the lines between improvisation and preparation. And that's something that I'm always amazed by.
Did you always have this title in mind, Parasite? Because obviously people will think just with the title, oh, it's a horror film or a sci-fi film, especially since you've done movies like The Host. It's, well, that makes sense. Here he's doing this again. It's anything but. And when you see the movie, oh my God, the title's so perfect. But did you have any qualms about putting it out there as that?
아니, 뭐 무슨 일부러 괴물의 그 호스트의 무슨 속편 느낌을 풍기려고 그런 뭐 이렇게 그런 이렇게 째째한 뭐 머리를 굴린 그런 것은 전혀 아닌데요.
So it wasn't as if I had this petty scheme to make Parasite seem like a sequel to The Host.
근데 뭐 약간 뭐 사이파이 같은 느낌이 있긴 있죠. 그 Parasite라고 하면 뭐 이렇게 바디 스네처 뭐 이렇게 막 확 나올 것 같고 막.
So Parasite does feel like a sci-fi title where, you know, a body snatcher film where something just explodes out of your body at one point.
근데 이제 이 영화의 출발점 자체가 어떤 이렇게 스며드는 거, 침투하는 거. 예. 저도 대학 다닐 때 이제 과외를 해 봤어요. 되게 부잣집 과외를 한 적이 있었는데 본의 아니게 이렇게 그 집에 그 가족의 어떤 사생활을 엿보는 느낌? 뭐 의도한 건 아니지만 그러니까 내가 그러니까 남의 집에 침투한 느낌 같은 거를 이제 그런 기묘한 느낌 받은 적이 있었거든요. 그래서 그것 자체가 기본 컨셉트여서 페러사이트를 하게 된 것 같아요. 페러사이트라는 제목을.
But the starting point of this whole story is the sense of infiltration. And when I was in college, I worked as a tutor for a rich family, and I had this eerie sense that I was spying on the private lives of complete strangers, although that's not what I intended at the time. And so that strange sense, feeling I had at that time and those memories, that was the beginning point of this film and, you know, the title Parasite.
So interesting. Let's see. We have a little time for some questions from the audience. So yes, go. Okay, he's asking about specific locations here and how that sparked the script.
Actually, 90% of the movie is all built set, rich house, poor house, all neighborhood of the whole town, whole poor town is all set, built in the swimming pool, water tank for the flood sequence. The only 10% of location is the big company of the rich guy, and also that the 그 길 비 올 때 막 내려오는 계단 길들 길거리 그것만 로케이션인데 로케이션이 10%뿐이 안 되다 보니까 이제 더 집요하게 우리가 찾아다녔죠. 로케이션 스카우팅을 전화 촬영 감독이나 또 로케이션 좋아하기 때문에 뭐 한풀이 하듯이 막 예.
So the sequence you see in the rain where the Kim family descends down through the stairs and back to their neighborhood, those are the ones shot on actual location. And because only 10% of the film was shot on location, we were more persistent with finding the right ones. The DP and I are both love shooting on actual locations.
그리고 이 두 이제 배우분들 이 가난한 가족이 있는 그 집 같은 경우도 물론 세트로 만든 거긴 하지만 실제 철거되는 그러니까 재건축되는 철거되는 가난한 동네에 있는 뭐 문짝 뭐 벽 이런 걸 뜯어와서 그 실제 때 묻은 오래된 재료를 가지고 또 만들기도 했어요. 그래서 되게 좀 리얼하죠. 그래서 모르겠어요. 뭐 배우분들이 어떤 그 집에서 실제 사는 감정을 그러니까 직접 느낄 수 있게끔 도움이 조금이라도 되고자 좀 애를 썼었더랬죠.
And for the poor house, the set, we built it, it's a set, but we actually went to neighborhoods that were scheduled to be demolished and reconstructed to take the doors, the wallpaper, and all those actually aged and old materials to build the set with. So it felt very real, and we tried hard to make sure that the audience can, to make sure that the actors can actually feel like it's somewhere that they live in.
Okay, yes, yeah. That's you, yeah.
마이크가 있으니까 이분이 할게요.
If you see the movie, you notice the idea of scent. The scent, it becomes such a strong item that you use it throughout the story. And you see where the, one of the park, the Mr. Park, see that talks about the subway smell. And was wondering if for the actors, if they felt like the movie itself had, when they were acting, if the how important that to them was when they're thinking about it, when they're acting about it, and how they imagine that scent.
저희 집에 있는 냉장고 있잖아요, 거실에. 그 냉장고의 문을 모두가 서로 한 번 연 이후로는 절대 열지 않기로 약속을 했어요.
I don't know if you recall the refrigerator that you see in the poor house. We, at some point in the beginning of the shooting, we, all of the Kim family at one point opened it. And then after that, we all agreed to never open that fridge again because of the scent.
미술 감독님께서 되게 좀 강박적인 리얼리즘에 또 추구하시는 분이라 실제 우리 쓰레기 봉지를 그 골목에
네, 맞아요. 실제로.
오래된 음식물 쓰레기 봉지를 갖다 놔서 네. 냄새가 나기도 했었죠.
그 정말...
물론 질문의 여지에서 약간 벗어나긴 합니다만 그런 게 있었어요. 네.
It's a little off topic, but our production designer was very obsessed with making sure that everything is real. So he actually brought actual old food trash onto the set to have it smell.
And it actually ended up rotting, so it was really smelly for the entire.
I love it. Oh, I have to go, but if it's real quick, I'll take you. Yeah, okay.
Can you share what inspires you of this great metaphor?
Oh, okay. What inspired that?
그 질문은 되게 예, 감사합니다. 그 받고 싶은 질문이었는데.
Thank you for that question. I wanted someone to ask that question.
여태껏 아무도 여쭤보는 분이 없어가지고. 예, 근데 그게 사실 두 번 나와요. 강호 형님이 이렇게 하는 게 두 번 나오는데 이 포스터의 막대기를 말씀하신 건가요? 아니면 영화에서 이거를 그 노플랜 얘기할 때 말씀하신 건가요? 아니면 둘 중 두 가지 다인가요?
So are you referring to the stick on the poster or when Song Kang-ho does this within the movie? This?
예. 노플랜 그거 할 때. 예. 그때 이제 사실 그게 아버지가 아들한테 할 소리는 아니잖아요. 되게 어떻게 보면 어두운 가슴 속에 있던 어떤 정말 평소에 하기 힘든 어떤 어두운 덩어리가 탁 빠져나오는 건데 그게 어떤 심정일까를 많이 생각을 해봤어요. 그러니까 이게 그 어떻게 보면 이 인물이 기택이란 인물이 어떻게 살아왔는지 그동안 힘들었던 삶의 어떤 냄새도 나는 거고. 예.
So that's something that a father usually doesn't say to his son. It's something that's very dark from deep within his heart. It's like he's taking out a dark lump from within him. And so I thought of what this character is feeling and what kind of life Ki-taek led and what struggles he's had.
그래서 스토리보드에도 그렇게 팔을 그리는 걸로 가려놓기도 했고 이제 강호 선배님 본인께도 한번 이 느낌이 어떨까 여쭤봤는데 본인도 마음에 들어 하셨고요. 그래서 그렇게 찍었죠. 그러니까 눈이 안 보이는 거죠. 그 되게 어떤 마음속 깊은 얘기를 하는데 입만 이렇게 움직이는 거 볼 수 있는 거죠. 거기서 오는 어떤 약간 깊은 느낌이 있지 않을까 생각이 들었고 사실 그 전에도 이 인물이 눈을 감는 모멘트가 몇 번 있어요. 영화에서 반복적으로. 예.
So that was also included in the storyboard where he covers his eyes, and I asked Song how it felt for him, and he said it felt right. And you know, when he's saying something very deep from his heart, but you don't see his eyes; you basically only see his mouth moving. So I thought that in itself could deliver some like very deep, stirring emotion. And even before that scene, you see Ki-taek closing his eyes at certain moments.
그래서 클라이맥스의 언급결에 이제 끔찍한 짓을 저질렀을 때도 눈을 찔끔 감는 모멘트가 있거든요. 그렇지만 이미 때는 늦었죠. 예, 그래서 기택이란 인물이 갖고 있는 뭐 여러 가지 복합적인 슬픔이나 예, 또는 뭐 세상을 피하고 싶은, 그러니까 자기가 저지른 일에서 자기가 피하고 싶은 마음 이런 것들이 예, 복합적으로 들어가 있는 것 같아요. 근데 뭐 저보다는 사실 뭐 직접 하신 배우분의 느낌이 더 정확할 것 같다는 생각도 들고요. 저는 그냥 제시만 했을 뿐이죠.
So even when in the climax he somehow ends up stabbing Mr. Park, you see a shot of him shutting his eyes tight, but at that point it's already too late. And I think that really shows the complicated layers of sadness that Ki-taek has experienced and also his desire to sort of avoid the world, to avoid the world from what he's done. But that was only my suggestion. I think the actor who performed it would know a lot better.
저는 두 가지로 이제 생각이 들더라고요. 그게 이제 약간 자조적인 느낌이었을 것 같아. 그동안 이 아들에게 이런 얘기를 할 수밖에 없는 아버지로서의 어떤 자조적인 어떤 슬픔 이런 느낌이었을 것 같고 또 하나는 어쩌면 아들에게 그런 얘기 노플랜을 얘기를 하지만 그것은 진심이 아니었을 수도 있다. 라는 생각도 들고 그래서 눈을 가리지 않을까라는 생각을 하고 연기를 했죠. 그게 뭐 근데 어떤 정답이 딱히 있을 필요는 없지 않나라는 생각이 듭니다. 예.
So I had two thoughts while I was acting that scene. First, I thought maybe it was to express this self-mocking sadness that he would feel as a father who has no choice but to tell this to his son. And secondly, perhaps, you know, when he was saying that he was talking about no plan to his son, maybe he didn't really mean it. But I don't think I don't think it's necessary to really give it some specific answer.
Well, thanks for that quick question. That was a really interesting conversation. And thank you guys for coming out here. Good luck with Parasite. They're going to go out this way, guys. Thank you.